The F1 rocket engine, five of which powered the first stage of the Saturn V, was absolutely colossal. It used a gas generator to drive a turbine which powered its fuel pumps. This turbine produced 55,000 horsepower, equivalent to the max combined horsepower of 62 Porsche 918 supercars. This power was used to pump a total of 40,000 gallons of fuel per minute, which was pushed into the combustion chamber at over 1,000 psi, or about 70 atmospheres of pressure. The controlled explosion in the combustion chamber reached a temperature of almost 6,000 degrees Fahrenheit, hot enough to boil iron. The exhaust gas was accelerated through the 12-foot-wide nozzle to a speed of Mach 7.5 and produced 1.5 million pounds of force. Rocket engines are some of the most sophisticated and powerful machines mankind has ever created. In this series of videos, we'll be looking in depth into how these impressive devices work. In this first part, we're talking about thrust and efficiency.
All right, liftoff, and the clock has started.
Liftoff.
We have a liftoff. 32 minutes past the hour. Liftoff on Apollo 11.
Discovery, go at throttle up.
Roger, nice to be in orbit.
A rocket engine's job is to create thrust. It's really their only job. And to create thrust, all rocket engines use Newton's third law of motion. This law tells us that every action has an equal and opposite reaction. So the action of the engine accelerating the rocket fuel out the back of the rocket has the opposite reaction of pushing the rocket forward. The amount of thrust a rocket engine produces is equal to the speed of the exhaust multiplied by the mass flow rate of the exhaust. And the mass flow rate of the exhaust is equal to the mass flow rate of the fuel being fed into the engine. By the way, mass flow rate just means how much mass goes through a system in a certain amount of time. Most of the time in these videos, we'll be describing this using the unit kilograms per second. If a rocket engine consumes 1,000 kilograms of fuel per second, and the exhaust velocity is 3,000 meters per second, then it will produce 3 million newtons of thrust. This equation shows us that if we want a rocket engine to produce more thrust so we can lift bigger rockets, we have to either increase the amount of fuel it uses or increase the exhaust velocity. This brings us into the topic of rocket engine efficiency. Just like with a car, higher efficiency means being able to do more with less fuel. In rocketry, fuel efficiency isn't given in miles per gallon, but in a term called specific impulse, which is often just shortened to ISP. Specific impulse is a measure of how much thrust an engine will produce by consuming a certain amount of fuel, which sounds a lot like exhaust velocity from the equation we just looked at. Specific impulse is usually measured in seconds. This has become the standard worldwide since a second is a universal standard of time. It is possible to measure it in a unit of speed, such as meters per second, by multiplying it by 9.8 meters per second per second. When measured this way, engineers usually call it effective exhaust velocity. Effective exhaust velocity isn't always the same as actual exhaust velocity. In engines where 100% of the fuel is fed into the combustion chamber, effective exhaust velocity and actual exhaust velocity are the same. But in many engines, a portion of the fuel is used for other tasks such as running fuel pumps or actuating hydraulics. In these engines, the effective exhaust velocity can be significantly lower than the actual exhaust velocity. Specific impulse and effective exhaust velocity are the real measurements of fuel efficiency and can be compared between all types of rocket engines. There are a lot of ways to increase efficiency in rocket engines. Fuel choice, engine cycles, chamber pressure, and nozzle shape all affect it. In future videos, we're going to be taking a look at each of these topics and how they influence the design of a rocket engine. But first, we need to get some more basics out of the way. In part two, we'll be talking about flow and pressure. This has been Liam from Space is Kinda Cool. Thanks for watching.